if in Libya there were groups who've gone out and done a rigorous job of documenting each of the alleged killings that have taken place, if they have that documentation, if they have, they were able to interview people who are around there who can say what police unit or what army unit or military was engaged in that area, so that you can, and then you're able to take a street map, find out where the forces who are moving in. If you can pull all of this data together, you'll have a stronger case of presenting this in a, before the International Criminal Court, which is going to be investigating the killings in Libya. So a lot of the prosecutors in these courts are in fact relying on these organizations on the ground to collect evidence that is court admissible. It, before the start of these international criminal courts, you didn't necessarily have to have evidence that was court admissible, but now you're going to get challenged. So the stronger, the more rigorous the evidence you can collect, the better off you are in actually achieving prosecutions.
Now that kind of a court inquiry might not take place for 5 or 10 years. What about immediately? What about while Gaddafi may or may not be harassing his population? Any use for this technique in that?
Well, there's the use is the social networking process that are being used by the demonstrators. If you recall in Iran, when the young woman was killed in a back alley, somebody videoed it. Someone had a cell phone and was able to capture that. And that went around the world. It was showing in real time what was taking place. And the reason that's important is because there are less and less correspondents, journalists on the ground because of the cutbacks in journalism and at newspapers and media outlets. And so now the reliance has to be on those local groups who are well trained in the documentation. Now it's important though that that documentation is viewed and questioned and scrutinized to make sure it's accurate, because that there's not any kind of manipulation, and that is something that has to be adhered to.